A string is basically what? It's a sequence of character. Sequence of character. A string is what? It's basically sequence of character. And suppose I'm going to use nm is equal to, and suppose I'm going to give Santosh. Like for the string, either we can go for the double quotation. We can use nm1 is equal to, like I'm going to use Smith. We can also use nm2 is equal to, we can go for the triple double quotation. I'm just going to use ln.
Again, we can use. See your screen.
Oh, sorry. I just forgot to say that. Okay. Now, so what we are going to start with today, it's earlier it was the list, it was the tuple. Now today we are going to start with a string. A string is what? It's a sequence of character. And to represent the string, either we can use the double quotation, or we can use the single quotation, or we can use the triple double quotation, or we can use triple single quotation over there. Like this. The advantage of using this triple double quotation and all, it can be, now your string can be of multiple line string can be there. It can be of multiple line. This is the advantage of using triple single quotation and double quotation. It will be of multi-line. If I'm going to use print nm2, run this, going to save the program. Yeah, we are getting this. So that is the advantage of using the double quotation and single quotation. Triple double quotation and single double quotation. And one important thing that we need to remember, like if I'm going to use print nm of 0, run this, nm of, we can access the value through the index, run this, we are getting s. Like we are going to use 2, we are getting n. Like we can go for the slashing over there. Like from the second position, I'm going to use 3 characters over there. Yeah, n. Like again, I'm going to use 225. Yeah, we are getting nto. So this is how we can get the value from the string. We can use the indexes over there. We can use the double quotation. We can use the single quotation. That we need to remember. We can also apply the negative indexing over there. Suppose I'm going to use print nm of -1. So we can apply the negative indexing also. Like if I'm going to use print nm of :3, run this. So these are the slashing. Slashing means what? You can get the value from the particular position and all. Now, suppose I need to delete the string. How we can do that? I'm writing del function is there, del, and the name of the string. I'm going to use nm. After the delete, if I'm going to write print nm, see what the output we are getting. Like nm is not defined. So remember, we can delete the string. And to delete the string, what we need to use? We just need to use the del over there. Remember, like for the string, to concatenate, what we can do? Suppose I'm just going to use print nm plus nm1. See, this is how we can concatenate the string. We can apply the plus operator. Suppose I'm going to use print nm multiply by 3. Run this. We are getting Santosh 3 times. So this is how we can apply the plus operator. This is how we can apply the multiplication operator over there. With the string, we can also use the parenthesis. Like I'm going to use s is equal to. In the parenthesis, I'm writing this one. And again, I'm going to give like this one. Close the parenthesis. And I'm going to use printf. We are getting this value. This is the single string. And just we are applying the parenthesis over there just to break the string and all. And one important thing, like with the string, even we can apply the loop also. Suppose I'm writing. Suppose I'm, this is the string we are having. Okay, I'm just writing for I in. And I'm giving the string over there. Like, I'm just writing this. For I in hello world. Now, if I need to check the occurrence of the particular character, like I want to find out how many times the O is there, like O I'm looking for. So I'm writing if I is equal to O. In that case, what we need to do, I'm just going to declare the variable C is equal to 0. And I'm writing in that case, what we need to do, I'm writing C is equal to C plus 1. And finally, I'm going to display print number of times C is comma, I'm just going to give C. Number of times C is 2. So this is how we can use, even you can apply the for loop with a string. That's the good thing. Even we can apply the for loop with a string. That's the good thing. And again, we can apply the membership operator over there. Suppose we are just going to write print n in nm. I'm looking for the n, whether it's available with the nm or not. So I'm just going to use the membership operator over there. And if I'm going to run this, see we are getting true. Means it's available. Suppose I'm going to give not in. So in Python, just to find the string, to get the string, and to iterate the string, it's really easy. Like we are having the in, we are having the not in operators over there. So we can do that. Like, remember, in Python, the important thing is string formatting. We can apply the string formatting. String formatting means what? String formatting means what? Suppose, I'm just going for the format this string. Like I'm writing print, or I'm just using x is equal to, I'm just using braces, comma, and dot format. Format is the method. Now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to give Santosh. I'm just going to give Shaman. I'm just going to give like Kin. I'm just, so now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to display the print X. We are getting these values, Santosh, Simon, and Kin. So this is how we can apply the format command over there. This is how we can apply the format command over there. And suppose I'm going to write X of 0. This will be the complete string over there, remember. If I'm going to use from 0, I'm looking for up to 6 or up to 10. Run this. See, we are getting like this. So what I'm trying to say, like even in the single variable, you can put the multiple values. If I'm going to give print X, see what the output. So even in the single variables, we can store the multiple values over there. And even the comma separator is there, even the ampersand is there. So this is how we can do, like by the use of format command. Format is a function that we can apply over there. And in this format, it's follow the default order. In this format, it just follow the default order. Default order means what? Like we are using the braces, accordingly, it's going to get the values. Like in the place of default order, what we can use, we can use the order using the positional argument. Positional argument means what? I'm just going to use order using positional argument. What I'm going to do, I'm just going to give like 1, I'm just going to like 2, and I'm going to give 0. So Santosh will get a sign over here, Simon will get a sign over here, and Kin will assign over here. Now if I'm going to write y is equal to, run this, and we are getting the result like this, print y. Run this, we are getting Simon, Keen, and Santosh. Initially we are getting Simon, then we are getting Keen, and then we are getting Santosh. So this is order using the positional argument. We can also specify order using keyword argument. We can specify the keyword over there. Like I'm going to use y of 120. In the place of 120, suppose I'm going to give A, I'm going to give B. This is the keyword I'm going to give. And here I am writing like A is equal to, like B is equal to, like C is equal to. These A, B, C are what? It's a key. So for the Santosh, you are going to assign the key A. For the Simon, you are going to assign the key B. For the Kin, you are going to assign the C. Now we are writing this, run. See, we are getting this value. So this is basically the format command. We can specify the format command with a string. Other than this, one important thing that we need to remember with the string, that is called escape sequence. Escape sequence means what? Suppose I want to display like this. I want to display the string and all, like A and B. I want to display like this. I need to display the double quotation also. So how we can do this? I'm just writing. Just we need to use the triple quotation over there. So just I'm going to use print. Like I'm going to use, he said, I'm using comma. Again, I'm using what is there. And I'm going to use this. Again, I'm going to close this. Now, what I need to do, I just need to use single quote, these things. So in Python, we are having the option, like we can use this triple single quotation or triple double quotation for these purpose. Like here we are using comma, here we are using double quotation. If I'm going to display this, see what we are getting. We are getting the double quotation as it is. We are getting the single quotation over there. So this is how we can apply. This is what is the use of this triple single quotation or triple double quotation. We can also use, suppose I'm using print and I want to skip this S, post of S I want to skip. So what we can use, we can also specify the slash over there. And now I'm just using the single quotation over there. So this single quotation will not the break of the string. It's going to escape that. So it will be the continuity of the string. Execute this. See, we are getting this single quotation. So what we can use slash over there just to escape that. If I need to escape the double quotation, we can use print double quotation. He said comma. Now we are using like this. Now the problem is this double quotation will be the termination of the string. But I need to escape this. So how we can do that? We just need to apply slash. Now it's escape sequence. Now this is what, this is your escape sequence. Here again we need to use the slash. This is how we can do this. Run. See. So we can apply the escape sequence over there. Like this is the string we are having. And what we are looking for, like I'm using slash. Now, after this line, what I'm looking for, I want to break the string. So we can use slash n. If I'm going to use, see, he said, now the line break is there. In the next line, we are getting this. So we are using slash n over there. So these are what, these are the escape sequence. Remember, in the escape sequence, we can use slash n. We can use slash single quotation. We can use slash double quotation. It's going to escape the double quotation. It's going to escape the single quotation. It's basically the line break that we can use. So these are the escape sequence in Python that we need to remember. And if we are going to use the triple double quotation, we don't need to use any escape sequence and all, directly we can do this. Now, so format string was, format methods were there, escape sequence is there. Now we are just going to use the common Python string methods, like a string function over there. A string function, like every programming language having some functions and all. Suppose I'm going to give like nm is equal to, I am writing the man of action is from Earth. This is the string we are having. Now, what I am looking for, I need to convert this into the uppercase. I am going to use print nm dot lower. It will get converted into the lowercase. If I am going to use print nm dot upper, the string will convert it into the uppercase. Now run this. See, it's get converted into the lowercase, it's get converted into the uppercase. Now what we can do, we can also split the string. I'm using k is equal to nm dot split. I'm using nm dot split. Remember, when we apply the split, it will split the string on the basis of space. It will split the string on the basis of space. And now I'm going to use print k. K is basically, it's a list. Now we can use, I'm just going to use for loop for I in k. And I'm going to use print I. Run this. See, your string get splitted. So this is what, after the splitting, it's going to make the list over there. It will make the list. And in the list, you can get the values and all. So this is how you can split the string. Suppose I'm going to use, I want to split the string at A. Run this. See, the string get splitted, but splitted at the position of A. The M, in this position it gets, so by default get splitted by the space. Other than the space, we can also specify the character over there. I'm just going to remove this. Now, so we are having the split function. A split function means what? It will divide the string. It will, and it will return your string into the list. Like we are having the split. In the place of a split, what we can apply? We can apply the join. So I'm just going to use print. I'm writing this dot. I'm going to use join. Join for what? I want to join the k. Run this. Now your string get joined. And if I'm not going to give this, in that case, what will happen? This will be the result. So this is what, this is basically the separator. If I'm going to give this, means what? After the every word, we are getting this. So we are having the join function to join the string. We are having the split function to break the string. So a split is there just to break. Join is there to join. Other than the split and join, what we are having, like I want to find out the occurrence of the particular character. I am writing print the lizard. And now I am going to write dot find. I am going to use the find over there. And I am looking for the position of E. Run this. Oh, sorry. I'm looking for the position of occurrence of E. We are getting 2. At the second position, we are having the E. 0, 1, 2. So find method is there. By the use of find method, you can find out the string positions and all. Suppose I'm going to give find 3. Run this. We are getting 5. 5 means what? After the third position, now the next is available on the 5. So either we can use, so basically this is the first occurrence we are having. This is the first occurrence. This is the first occurrence. What we can do, and is going to find out, it will return the first occurrence. And this will return occurrence after 3, third character. So this is how we can use the find statement over there. Like I'm going to use print the legend dot. I'm going to use replace. And what I need to replace? I need to replace the E with XYZ. So in the place of E, what will you get over there? XYZ. This is how we can use the replace function. So we are having the join, we are having the split, we are having the lower, we are having the upper, we are having the find, we are having the replace. These things we need to remember. Like, suppose my question is, it's related with the string. Suppose my question is, write a program to sort words in alphabetical order. My program is, you just need to write a program to sort the words in alphabetic order. How we can do this? I need to write a program to sort the words in alphabetic order. How we can do this? Yes, please. Any idea from your side? Suppose this is the string I'm going to give. NM. Input. Enter. A string. This is the string we are having. Now what we need to do, we just need to arrange this in alphabetic order. Yeah, how we can do this? Yeah, Joshua?
I think it has a sort method, right? A sort function?
Yeah, sort function is there, but it's not with the string. What we can do, we can just split the string.
Yeah, I was gonna say that.
I'm just going to use the split, n1 dot split. After the split, what will happen? All the words get into the list. Now what we can do? We can use x dot sort. Because it's a list. Now we are applying the sort. And finally we are using, what I need to do, I just need to display the words. So I'm using for I in x, print x, run this, enter a string. I'm going to give like see what we are getting. Oh, it's the same one. Print I'm just going to give like enter string. I'm going to use dbca. See why we are getting the same thing?
Because split, I think you need a spaces for it.
Yeah, exactly. It's a wrong input. ABCD, XYZ, DCBA, PQR. See what we are getting? Initially, it's ABCD is there. After that, we are having the DCB. After that, we are having the PQWR. And after that, we are having XYZ. So this is how we can do this. We just need to apply the split function over there. Suppose, like we are having the function called, I am writing print. The man of action dot. Now we are having the method called capitalize. We can use capitalize. Run this. See. Basically, it will make every word in uppercase over there. Oh, do one thing. I'm just going to use x dot capitalize. Run this. Every word, first letter we are getting capitalized. It's a sentence character. Suppose I want to display print nm9 dot. I'm looking for the len. Len function is there. I'm using len of nm9. Run this. It's a 14 characters there. So what I'm trying to say, these are the different functions that we can use with a string. We can use the escape sequence over there. We can use these formats over there. This is how we can apply the slashing over there. For the string, we can use the single quotation or double quotation and all that we can do. It's clear?
I have a question.
Yeah, please.
Yeah, you say... that the dot capitalized method only capitalized the first letter?
Yeah, it's a sentence character. Sentence letter.
Yeah, that's kind of weird. Okay.
It's a sentence like, this is the sentence we are having. the first character is going to convert into the capital.
Okay, so you use two upper method to do all of them, right?
Yeah. Two upper is basically for all the string. If I'm going to convert it into upper, it's for basically for the all string. If I'm going to use dot upper, run this. Everything is in the uppercase.
Okay.
So we are not looking for every character. So what we need to do, just we need to use the capitalize. So this is how we can apply the strings and all. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm just going to make copy, Control C. And I'm just going to paste it in the notepad. After this, so list, tuple, and string, it's get completed for us. Now the next thing I'm going to start with, it's a set. Set is basically what? It's an ordered collection of item. An ordered collection of item. For the set, what we need to use? Just we need to use the braces over there. An ordered collection of unique items, that will be the better option. Suppose I'm going to use m is equal to now I'm going to use printf. We are getting, as such there is no any sequence over there. And what we are getting? We are getting the unique values only. Even we can also apply, like I'm writing, I'm using m is equal to. It can be of mixed data type. Like I'm using this one, comma. Again, I'm using like this. Print M1. I'm using like this. Oh. We are getting this value. Remember, even we are applying the set, but still the duplicate value is there. Why? Because within the set, you are just using the tuple over there. And the tuple is not going to follow that particular rule. That's why we are getting even the duplicate values over there. So might be in the interview, they will ask you the question, how we can put the duplicate values in the set. So what options we can use over there? Just we can apply set over there. Within the, we can apply the tuple over there. Even we can apply the list over there. Do this. M2. Run this. List is not allowed. List is not allowed over there. Now, the important thing with the set is, like, this is the advantage of the set. Like, you don't need to bother about the unique values. And always it will arrange the data accordingly. Suppose we are having the list. In the list, we are having the duplicates value and all. What we can use? We can use print set of A. See, that's get converted into the set. even one important thing. What we can do, like, we can also create the set like this. Like, I'm going to use b is equal to. It's a blank set. If I'm going to write print type of b, run this. Remember, when we are going to like this, this braces, by default, it will be of dictionary type. It will be of dictionary type. But if I'm going to use, c is equal to, I just need to apply the set over there. Like this. And now I'm going to use print type of C. Run this. So to make the blank set, what we need to use, we just need to use the set like this. If I'm going to use the braces, like earlier it was in the list, it was in the tuple, that will make, basically it will be by default, it will be of dictionary type. That we need to remember. And in this particular set, suppose I need to add some item over there. So what we can do, I'm just going to add C dot add. I'm going to add 2 over there. C dot add. I'm going to add 3 over there, 34 over there. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to print C. Run this. So this add method is there. You can even add the value over there. Even we can apply. Suppose I'm going to use C dot update. C dot update. And in the update, what I'm going to give, like 2, 3, 4. Run this, print C. Earlier it was 2 and 34. Now we are having 2, 3, 4 and 34. So even you can update the existing set. 2 was there. And again, you are going to add the 2 over there. So basically, it contains only the unique values. That's why we are getting only these things. So even we can, for the single value, what we can do, we can use add. And for the multiple value, what we can use update. For single value, we can use add. And for multiple values, what we can use update. This is the tricky question for multiple values. The question will be, what is the difference between add and update? If I need to put the multiple values, we will go for the update. If I need to put the single value, we will go for the add. How to make the blank set? When we use the set like this, it will be by default of dictionary type. To make the set blank, we need to use set function over there. So we are using C is equal to set and all. We can also update like this. I'm going to use C dot update. I'm going to use like this 2, 3, 4 comma. I'm just going to use like this. Like this. Run this. So you can update like this also. The multiple values and all. Now the question is how to remove the values. To remove the values, what we need to do, we can use the name of the set, like C dot. We can use discard. Discard function is here. And I'm going to discard 3 from the list, from the set. Print C. Run this. Earlier 3 was there, now it's get removed. So we can use what? We can use discard. And this is what? This is the item that you need to give. It's not the index number and all. We need to remember. So we can use discard. We can also use, like I'm going to use C dot remove. And what item I need to remove? I want to remove the 2 from the list, from the set. And again, I'm going to use print C. Run this. Now 2 is not there. Earlier, the 3 get removed. Now 2 get removed. So these are the value we are having. So to remove the value from the set, what we can use, either we can use discard or we can use the remove over there. Suppose I'm going to use, I'm writing C dot discard, and I'm just going to give the item that is not available over there. I'm just going to discard the item, and this item is not available over there. If I'm going to write print C, nothing will happen. Nothing will happen. It's the same result we are getting. So it will not return you the true and false that we need to think about. Like, it's not going to return you the true and false. Like, we are having the remove over there, we are having discard over there. The same way, what we can use, we can use the pop. We can use the pop. Like, I'm going to use she dot pop. Pop method is there. Again, I'm going to use the pop. See. Again, I'm going to use the pop. Run this. See. The first time after discarding the 2, these are the items we are having. Okay. Now we are using C dot pop. So 34 get removed. Now again we are using dot pop. The 4 get removed. Now again we are using the pop. Now this particular value get removed. So this is how we can use the pop. Pop means what? It will remove the item from the beginning. And if I need to remove all the item from the set, how we can use? We can use C dot. I'm going to use clear. And finally, I'm going to use print C. Nothing will be there. Nothing is there. It's a blank. So clear will remove all the item. Pop will remove the item from the beginning. By the use of discard and remove, you can remove the particular item. That we need to think about. Now, one important thing is, like, see, we are having the set. Pardon?
Like, we are using the pop, so can we also use a push to enter?
No. As such, there is no any push method.
Okay.
Yeah, well, it's only pop.
Oh.
Okay. Now, what I'm trying to say, like, see, because we are having the set. Okay, I'm going to define the set. This is the set we are having. Again, I'm going to define this. Because it's a set, with the set we can apply union, we can apply intersect. So even we can apply the union and all. For the union, what we can do, I'm just going to write print. I'm just going to use print A, filter B. This filter is what? It's a union operator. Run this. We are getting the result like this. Union means what? It will combine the result. We are getting all these value. So this is how we can use the union. For the union, we just need to use this pipe symbol. Filter. Other than this pipe symbol, we can also use, like, union function is also there. Like, I'm going to use print A dot union B. So either we can use this pipe symbol or we can use the union function. Other than the union, we can also use the intersection. like I'm going to use print a ampersand b. This is the intersection operator. We are getting only the common values. 33 and 22, these two are common in both the list. So this is your intersection. Other than this, we can also use print a dot intersection. A dot intersection of B. If I'm going to run this, again we are getting the same result. So we are having the intersection. Other than this, we can also use the difference, the minus operator. Like for the difference, what we need to use, I am writing print A minus B. Run this. We are getting 11 and 44. 11 and 44 is available with the A, but it's not available with the B. Difference is just like your minus. Unique of the first. Unique of first. Suppose I'm going to use print. We can also use the function A. I'm using A. Difference. A difference B. Run this and we are getting the result. So this is how we can use the difference over there. So we are having the union, we are having the intersect, we are having the differences, and these things we can apply with the set. Other than this, we are having the symmetric difference. Other than this, we are having the concept of symmetric difference. Suppose I'm going to write print, I'm using A, caret symbol, and B. Run this. We are getting 66114455. 66114455. But we are not getting 22 and 33. So other than the common element, we will get over there. These are the elements that are not common. So other than the common element, we will get. We can also use the like print A and A dot. We can use symmetric difference. We can use symmetric difference. Symmetric difference between B. Yeah, we are getting the result. So this is all about the set. How we can apply union, how we can apply intersect, how we can apply minus, how we can remove the item, discard is there, remove is there, pop is there, clear is there, and how we can add the value, how we can remove the values, how to create the blank set. So this is really, everything is there, it's related with the